Hey, welcome back. Today's video, I will show you how to paint nice looking sunset. So, don't go away. I'm Toby. This channel here is all about showing you how to draw and paint. So, make sure you hit the subscribe button here not to miss any new episode. So, we start here with the center part of this painting, the sun itself. Mixture of titanium white and a bit yellow, and then we put around the colors that we need to achieve to get to this brownish red tone on the bottom part of the painting here. As you see, I put in the colors roughly, more or less. Different colors mixed together before. And yeah. Looks pretty rough at the moment still, but I grab my wonder weapon, this blender brush here, and we have a nice transition from the sun to the lower part of the darker part of the painting here. Now we start to put in the clouds themselves here. They are pretty dark. A mixture of blue and reddish. And yeah, here we put in the lighter part of the clouds. As you see, the more you get towards to the sun, the lighter the cloud needs to be. And of course, blending is always the key. And you want to have some smooth transitions here. Need a big and very soft brush for this, but then it is like an airbrush. It's really fantastic. As you see, we have these lots of these darker colors here, the more reddish ones, and try to get them on, as you can see here now. It looks at the moment pretty rough, but when we get over them with the blender brush, then this will all look much smoother and much better. So here we put in now the lighter part. And here the lighter part of the cloud here. And you can see we have basically, I would say, 3, 4, 5 different colors that we premixed for this cloud color. And we put them in. More or less roughly, and we start to blend them to have these really nice transitions and really soft airbrush-like appearance that clouds mostly have. This here is now the lower part of the sky. As you see, it's a bluish-grayish color here. And this is basically the lighter blue that we have, and this darker blue on the part that you can't see at the moment, or you won't see it anyway, is the color that determines the color of the shadows. And that means that you have to put in a lot of bluish tones here on the darker parts of the clouds to make them look really realistic. And again, as you see, the closer you get to the sun, the lighter the color needs to be to have this realistic appearance here. We blend in this bluish grayish here, and we start to work on this cloud again. And this time I wanted to have this cloud really blending into this bluish on top of it. So I already did a lot of blending work on the upper part here. Still looks pretty rough, but again, this magic weapon here comes into play. Yeah, now I put in the second cloud here, or the third one. As you see, this is a pretty bluish color here, a very dark one. And this cloud here emerges from the background more or less. So we have these lighter colors again here on this part here. But you will soon see that I put into darker tones like this one here, and even darker ones like this here, to get this really fleshed out. Here now I'm using a little first smaller brush for blending. Then again my favorite tool. And you see we have this really nice connection between these lighter reddish colors here and this really bluish looking, nearly black shade of this cloud here. And again, the closer you get to the sun, the lighter the color needs to be. And back then in my starting days, I tried to blend this with a smaller brush, but this is takes forever, and the effect is not as good as when you use this bigger brush. So, yeah, the best tools ever if it comes to getting smooth transitions on a larger scale. And now putting in the bit lighter part of this dark part here. And this looks too rough, of course, so we need to merge these two colors together a bit better. So now we put in the detail part of the cloud. Some little parts of the cloud that are floating around. And if they are a bit too dark, just grab your finger and wipe it out. And this is now the part where we put in the highlight from the sun. And this is, I think, the key part to this painting here, because only then the cloud really looks realistic. And as you can see, my hand rests on the painting, so I let the painting cure for I think 2 or 3 days to get it really completely dry, so that I can dry brush this lighter color here on without interfering with the color that I put this white color over. And basically, this whole thing is done. On the whole center part of this painting here. And I think this makes the 3D effect really coming forward. This is really the way to go when you paint clouds, that you, at least in this kind of light situation, that you put this highlights onto the clouds and they start really to emerge from the background and start to look really realistic. Putting some more smaller clouds in the background. These are basically just yellow and white. And of course, some more details more on the foreground. Again, some lighter tones here in this cloud here. A bit more depth to it. And we have some pretty light clouds that also are strongly lit, so we also need to put in this white yellowish color here. When it gets too strong, you can just use your finger and wipe it off. As you can see here, and this is a big advantage of this dry brush technique here. So here we put in our more details, darker ones. The clouds that are more in the foreground here. And as we put in the color pretty thin, we can go over to the softer brush and make this whole thing softer. With this little kind of blender brush, I would call it. And I think the painting lives out of these details here, this sunlight coming from the reflected from the clouds, and this small little specks and pieces of the clouds that are floating around. I think this makes the painting really come to life. Some more darker highlights here around the cloud here. Even more lighter with more titanium white and bluish. Some color variations, no? And we are finished, and not too shabby, I think. If you want to learn more about how to paint clouds, I have two videos here. Link is somewhere here, where I will show you in detail how to paint nice looking clouds. So check them out.